One day many Sri Lankan monks believe in the Abhidhamma. What do you think about the Abhidhamma?
Abhidharma. What is called Abhidharma is something that we have given up. I think Venerable Dhamma Buddha has given up Abhidharma. I have also given up Abhidharma. Abhidharma is really an effort to interpret the original teachings of the Buddha. And there are mistakes in that interpretation. But they called it Abhidharma because there was this conflict between the Theravadins and the Mahayana people. That conflict is really because you see, you have to understand that in order to understand the problem, that after about 100 years after the disappearance of the Buddha, a lot of people became Buddhist monks. Because the Buddhist monks were treated well by the public. So to get the benefits, people became monks. But they were not interested in practicing the Vinaya rules. Vinaya rules are the rules of the monk. They didn't want to practice the rules. And they started saying, let us change the Vinay rules to make it easy. And the senior monk said, no, we cannot change the Vinay rules which were laid down by the Buddha. And they refused. So these other monks who wanted to change the Vinay rules, they said, in that case, we take a vote. So they took the vote. Who won? People who wanted to change the Vinay rules won. That is what happened. And so the senior monk said, well, if you want to change the Vinay rules, you can do it because you have won, but we separate from you. And then they were saying that there is a sutra where the Buddha says, in future, my followers will begin to not follow my higher teachings. They will follow only my lower teachings. The higher teachings like sunyata, they will not follow. When the senior monks said this, there was a leader among these monks who wanted to change the Vinay rules. He said, don't worry, we will answer the public. And they convened a public meeting where all the lay followers came. And they said, that monk, he was a fairly intelligent man. And he said, why do these senior monks want to follow the Vinay rules? The only reason is they want to become arahant. This is why they want to follow the Vinaya rules. We don't want to become Arahants. And ask, what do you want to do? We want to become Buddhas. They said, we want to become Buddhas. And to become Buddhas, you don't have to follow the Vinaya rules. You have to follow only the paramitas. And they said, we are going to follow the paramitas and we are going to become Buddhas. But the lay followers didn't know that if these people can't follow the Vinaya rules, how can they follow the paramitas, which are even more difficult? They didn't realize that. They said, oh, these people want to become Buddhas. That is better than becoming Arahants. So let us support them. So that is how Mahayana started. That is Mahayana, trying to become the Buddha. But they didn't really follow the paramitas because that is not an easy job. But they continued to break the Vinaya rules, and they adopted their own rules. And now the Mahayanists have started saying that when you become a Mahayana, you have to take a vow. What is the vow? Till all people in the world have entered Nirvana, we will not enter Nirvana. What does that mean? If that is going to happen, no one will enter Nirvana. You see, they have automatically given up Nirvana. That is what automatically happened. So, this way they started changing the teachings and the sutras and all those things. They started creating new sutras, and that is how it went on. So, Theravadins preserved the original sutras, and then what they did was, the Mahayanis started saying, we are talking only about sunyata, that is the higher teaching. The Theravadins are talking about the lower teachings, they started saying. But they couldn't really explain the meaning of sunyata. And the Theravadins began to say, no, we are not teaching the lower teachings. We are going to talk about the higher teachings. And higher teachings means Abhidharma. So the word Abhidharma really meant higher teaching. So that is how the word Abhidharma came into being. Before that, there was no such thing as Abhidharma. So from there on, gradually, the teaching started deteriorating. Gradually, they started mainly talking about karma and rebirth. They stopped talking about what are called the Four Noble Truths.